down, sit down. If you don't know, I'm Wardy, Mr. Betts' substitute teacher. Now, Mr. B's worked like a whole 3 weeks this year, so little baby needed a day off. Anyway, I'd like to talk to the ladies right now, so fellas, go do something else. Probably leave nasty comments on YouTube videos, because everybody knows, for every mean video comment, there's a sad teenage boy behind it. Ladies, Halloween is almost upon us, and soon, you'll be thinking about costumes. Perhaps you want to be Wonder Woman, or Harley Quinn, or even Naughty SpongeBob. Wait, is that a thing? Why is that a thing? The point is, don't. A, about a million other girls are gonna be them, and B, Halloween's in October. You're gonna freeze your tuchus off. Might I suggest you go as one of these savage heroines of the American Revolution? Nancy Morgan Hart. Hart's the best! She was at least 6 feet tall and carved out of wood. Living down in Georgia, she was in charge of the farm while her hubby was away fighting for the Patriots. For fun, she'd wander into British camps dressed like a man and acting like a literal idiot. They'd make fun of her, sure, but at the same time, they'd accidentally let top secret info slip. Info Hart would go tell the Patriots about. Also, when one of her daughters caught a British soldier peeping in on her, Hart showered him with boiling hot water and turned him over to all guys. But Hart's best known for what happened when a group of Brits killed her last and favorite turkey and demanded she cook it for them. Oh, you don't mess with Hart's favorite turkey. She played along, got them stupid drunk, and then started stealing their guns away. Halfway through, they caught on. Now, they were about to run into two problems. One, Hart had a rifle in each hand, and two, she was cross-eyed, so they couldn't tell who she was looking at. Two soldiers tried to bum-rush her, and she shot them both dead on the spot. It's said that the others were captured and hung by a tree in Hart's backyard while she sang Yankee Doodle. I ain't making this stuff up. Sybil Ludington. Who? Yeah, I know. You ain't never heard of her. Well, have you heard of William Dawes, or Samuel Prescott, or Paul Revere? Well, Sybil makes them look like a bunch of punks. See, it was 2 years after Lexington and Concord, and a bunch of British soldiers were drunk in Danbury, Connecticut, raiding ammunition stores and burning everything to the ground. The head of the local militia, Colonel Henry Ludington, had a problem. His militia had disbanded, being that it was the planting season. Yeah, leaving the front lines to plant turnips used to be a thing. So he sent Sybil, his oldest child who knew the area like the back of her hand, out to reassemble all 400 militiamen. And she did, riding all night long through territory loaded with Brits and bandits in the pouring rain. When it was all said and done, she had covered 40 miles in a single night, more than twice as much as those Boston boys, and she didn't even get herself captured like that knucklehead Revere. The militia was able to do some serious damage to the British, and Sybil, well, she was forgotten by history because Longfellow didn't write a highly inaccurate poem about her. Oh well. Margaret Cochrane Corbin. This one would be especially great if you had a cannon lying around. See, Margaret never had it easy. She was orphaned in 1751 when Indians killed her pops and kidnapped her moms. Mind you, she was 5 years old at the time. And while others might have cracked, this just made her tough as nails. Cut to the start of the revolution when her husband, John, went off to fight. And she said, "You ain't leaving me here." She followed the camp, earning money by cooking and cleaning and nursing. Still, she wanted more. More time with her hubby and more action. So she started dressing up like a man, a common theme as it seems, and helping John man his cannon. But during the Battle of Fort Washington, John was picked off by Hessian muskets. Freaking Hessians. They might look like doofuses with the hat and all, but they were terrifying to colonists. Don't believe me? Guess who was said to be a Hessian? The freaking headless horseman of Sleepy Hollow, that's who. Anyway, instead of crying or mourning, Margaret said, "Oh no, you didn't," loaded up her dead husband's cannon and fired back. Those around her were cheering her on, calling her Captain Molly. That is, until she too was hit in the jaw on the left arm. She would eventually be captured, released, lose the use of her arm, and would be the first woman in America to receive a lifetime military pension. Well, a half pension, because sexism! So there's three savage women of the American Revolution you can dress as without catching hypothermia. Let me know in the comments what you're gonna be for Halloween. Or you could always go as a member of Mr. Betts' class with this new Mr. Betts' class t-shirt featuring yours truly. About time I get some recognition around here. Follow the link in the description to get yours. Make sure you like this video, subscribe if you haven't, and hopefully Mr. Betts gets over his case of lazy bums and is back next week. See ya!